Well, I got the Thunderbird all put back together, the 1957 Thunderbird, and what I did to it was put in an electric fuel pump because I don't want to be stranded on the road with vapor lock. And I went ahead and put a better fan, I put a clutch fan on the engine, and cleaned up a few things under there because she was running a little hot. So started it up today, everything's great, sounds great. Except I noticed a little clunky under the hood, especially when I accelerated. And I thought, well, maybe it's the fan, maybe something's poking in there, but no, I've got enough clearance. And right now it's quiet, but I'm going to show you something. I don't know if you can see. Let's go to the other side. I'm going to take a look at this. All right. Look over here. Let's see. You can see the vibration damper. Now, you can see the big weight on the right side. It is in the correct place right now because I pushed it there. A couple of minutes ago, that big weight was far to the left. It was just kind of bouncing around on the small end of the vibration damper. It's out of the way. So, this is going to be replacing the vibration damper. And that is after I had the radiator out, put a clutch fan in, cleaned everything up, doing a bunch of stuff, put the raunchy old AC out of it, all kinds of stuff. So anyway, that's where we're at. But it just sounds good, but I know that that's not going to last because that vibration battery will swing loose again and it's going to come right down and make a bunch of noise. So here we go. Hey, it's a beautiful machine. Runs great. Sounds good. I like everything about it. Except it's a neat machine.